Hi all, I'm Ankur Gupta. Hope all of you are doing well and welcome to Analytics School. Today we will discuss about confidence interval. When we run studies, we want to be confident in the results from a sample. Confidence intervals show us the likely range of values of a population statistical measures such as mean, median, standard deviation, odds ratio and other statistical measures. In this session, we will focus on how to calculate confidence interval for the mean. Before we continue our discussion on confidence interval, let's have a situation to understand confidence interval in a better way. There are 1.4 billion people in India, and let's say Government of India wants to calculate average height of women in India. Although Government of India is interested in measuring this parameter, however, reaching out to such a large population in India, it is going to be too costly and time consuming to collect the data for each and every individual in order to calculate the population parameter. So how we can calculate the population parameter? We typically take a random sample that is representative of the population and use that data from the sample to estimate the population parameter. But there is a problem that average height of the woman in the sample is not guaranteed to be the population mean height of the woman in India due to some errors such as data entry error and uncertainty, even though sample has been conducted with all due diligence. So how we can overcome this uncertainty? In order to capture this uncertainty, we calculate confidence interval. So what is confidence interval? A confidence interval is a range of values that is likely to contain a population parameter with a certain level of confidence. Analysts often use confidence interval at 90%, 95% or 99% confidence level for various statistical measures such as mean, standard deviation, variance, etc. Thus, if a point estimate for the height of women in India with a 95% confidence interval of 5 feet 2 inches to 5 feet 6 inches, it can be inferred that there is 95% probability that the population mean of the woman height in India falls between that range. But there is a misconception regarding confidence interval, is that they represent the percentage of the data from a given sample that falls between the upper and the lower bounds. This is incorrect. It should be inferred as that there is a 95% probability that the population parameter falls within that range, although there is a separate method of a statistical analysis, that is Gaussian distribution analysis, through which one can determine what percentage of the data from a given sample that falls within the upper and lower bounds. There are certain assumptions to check for confidence interval. When constructing confidence interval, it is important that certain assumptions are met. If these assumptions are violated, then the confidence interval can become unreliable. One should check these assumptions when constructing a confidence interval. Assumption 1 is random sampling. The data should be collected using random sampling method, and the sample data you are working on should be representative of the population of interest. Assumption number 2, independence. Each observation in the sample data should be independent of each and every observation. This means that no two observations in a sample are related to each other in any way. If you use random sampling method to collect the data, this assumption is typically met. Assumption number 3 is large sample size. In a statistic, sufficiently large sample is considered to be 30 or greater. However, the number can be vary based on the underlying shape of the population distribution. If the distribution of the data is extremely skewed, then the sample size should be greater than 45 or more. Here is one thing that I would like to mention, that if the sample size is large enough, i.e. sample is greater than 30, then we use z-score. And if sample size is less than 30, then we use t-score. However, I do not recommend to calculate confidence interval less than 30, but theoretically one can do it. As I had mentioned in the beginning of the session, that we are going to focus mainly on how to calculate confidence interval for mean. If you see this formula, confidence interval is equal to sample mean plus minus z-score into the standard error of the mean. Let's understand what is the difference between the standard deviation and standard error. Standard error of the mean is standard deviation divided by root n. So basically the difference between standard deviation and standard error of mean is that standard deviation, it assesses how far a data point likely falls from the mean, whereas standard error of the mean, it assesses how far a sample statistics likely falls from a population parameter. Now let's do some examples and see how we can calculate confidence interval of mean. The dataset which we are going to work on is the fish dataset, and one can access it from the SAS help library. Let's see the top 5 records of our fish dataset. We are going to use proc print command, data equal to SAS help dot fish observation equal to 5. Let's run it. So you can see here there are 7 variables: species, weight, length 1, length 2, length 3, height and width. Species is a categorical variable, whereas all other variables are numerical. Let's verify the data types also by using proc contents statement. Proc contents data equal to SAS help dot fish, and let's run it. We do not have any errors or warning. There are 159 records and 7 variables. And you can see here, species is a character data type, whereas all the other variables are numerical data type. And we are going to calculate the confidence interval of mean for numerical variable height. It is always a good practice to know that whether the variable we are analyzing is normally distributed or not. And let me emphasize on this point that if the sample size is large enough, i.e. greater than 30, then we can say that variable is normally distributed due to the central limit theorem. But it is still good to know that the variable we are analyzing follow Gaussian distribution or not. So let's conduct the normality test. ODS graphics on. We are going to use proc univariate for this. Proc univariate data equal to SAS help dot fish. Our target variable is height. ID species. Histogram. Height. Normal. Mu equal to EST, sigma equal to EST. Let's have inset with skewness and curtosis. We are also going to have probability plot for height, normal, mu equal to EST, sigma equal to EST, and let's have the inset of skewness and curtosis for variable height. And let's run a code. Let's see a log window. There is no error or warning. What we are interested in to see whether the variable height follows the normal distribution or not. You can see here, the variable height, it seems to be normally distributed, but on the left hand side, the tail is heavy tailed. Let's analyze the probability plot also. And you can see here, probability plot generally follows the normal distribution, but there are certain outliers on the left hand side. So by plotting histogram and specifically prop plot, we can get an idea whether variable height is normally distributed or not. You can see in the probability plot that it seems normally distributed, but there are some outliers on the left side of the tail. Let's conduct a normality test on the variable height and our null hypothesis. Let me write normality test. A null hypothesis is height is normally distributed. An alternate hypothesis is height is not normally distributed. So basically, if p value is greater than 0.05, then the variable height is normally distributed. Let's run the normality test using proc univariate. ods select test for normality proc univariate data equal to SAS help dot fish normal test where height and run. And you can see here the p value is less than 0.05. Hence we can say that our variable height is not normally distributed. However, as I mentioned it earlier, that if the sample size is greater than 30, we can say that the variable is normally distributed due to central limit theorem. Now let's see which SAS procedures are going to help us to calculate the confidence interval of mean for a variable height. The first SAS procedure which we are going to see is proc univariate. Calculate confidence interval for height using proc univariate. There are various methods. I will show you three of them. ODS select basic intervals proc univariate data equal to SAS help dot fish. Now the option which you are going to use here is CI basic. This is going to help us calculate confidence interval for our variable height. Variable height and run. And you can see here, we have successfully calculated the confidence interval of mean using proc univariate procedure. And in the output window, you can see here, it is giving you the point estimate, which is 8.97, and 95% confidence limit falls between 8.29 to 9.64. And you can see here, we also have the confidence interval for standard deviation as well as for variance. But since we are focusing only on confidence interval of mean, and I've shown you the formula also that how we can calculate the confidence interval of mean for any numerical variable. Similarly, there are formulas for standard deviation and variance also. Now we are going to see how we can use proc means to calculate confidence interval. Proc means data equal to SAS help dot fish. Let me reduce the decimal to two places only. I want to have number of observations, mean, standard error of mean. So there are two options in proc means to calculate the confidence interval. One is CLM, and I'll show you the other one in another example. Variable height run. And you can see here, we have successfully got the confidence interval for a variable height using proc means procedure, which is 8.30 to 9.64. The same result what we have got in proc univariate. Sorry, my bad. So as I had said that there are two options through which you can calculate confidence interval of mean by using proc means. Let me show you what is the other way. In place of CLM option, there is LCLM, which is lower bound confidence interval, and the upper bound confidence interval. And the output is going to be the same. So it is your choice what you are going to use. We can also calculate the confidence interval using proc t-test. Let me show you. Proc t-test data equal to SAS help dot fish where height. Here I have not mentioned the null hypothesis. We will discuss about t-test in detail later on in another session. Right now, I'm just showing you another method how we can calculate confidence interval of mean for any numerical variable by using Proc T-Test. Let us run the code. So you can see here, we have calculated the confidence interval of mean by using Proc T-Test. So I had shown you the three methods through which you can calculate confidence interval of mean in SAS. When we have looked at a fish data set, we have a categorical variable called species. And let's say we are interested in calculating the confidence interval of mean for each species. Let's see how we can do that. Let me copy and paste the code. I'm going to use a Proc Univariate first. Basic intervals. Let me get the moments also. And the only thing which you have to mention here is class statement. Let us run the code. And you can see there is a species called bream. There are 35 observations. And this is my point estimate, which is 15.18. And 95% confidence limit is 14.50831 to 15.85811. Whereas for perch, there are 56 observations, mean is 7.86, and 95% confidence limit is 7.09 to 8.63. Similarly, you can see for other categories also. Now, if I have to report this result to the stakeholders, I am going to report the result for sample size greater than 30 only. So basically, I'm going to report the result from bream and perch. For other species, they do not have the large enough sample size. I will not recommend you to make any decisions for other species. Similarly, we can easily calculate confidence interval for each species type using Proc Means. Let's see that. Let me copy the code. The only thing which you have to add here is class statement. Let's run the code. And you can see, we can also use Proc Means to calculate confidence interval for each species type. However, if you will try to use Proc T-Test to calculate the confidence interval of mean for fish dataset for each and every species, it is going to give an error. Because Proc T-Test works only on two categories. Let me show you. T-Test. Data equal to SAS help.fish variable height class species run. And you can see it has thrown an error to us. The class variable has more than two levels. And we will discuss about all this thing in the session when we will be discussing about the Proc T-Test. By this example, we come to an end of this session. I hope you guys have learned something new today. Talk to you soon, guys. Take care and have a great day.